Hey Eric, so I found a nice little spot to run you through a little flow of my traditional style yoga. Pretty much on top of the world. So we're up on the top of Notch Hill here in the Noose Bay. Okay, so I'll start you off with the same thing that I tell everybody before my class. Number one, don't hurt yourself. If something doesn't feel right, just come out of it, take a breath, regain yourself, and then come back in. You want to go to the point of discomfort when you're stretching, but you really don't want any pain, right? So try to find that fine line. Number two, use your breath. Really focus your exhales into the muscle that you're stretching, and then release that muscle on your exhale as you let it loose, as you stretch it out, right? You'll get way more flexibility out of it. Drink lots of water, and don't be afraid to stop, pause, rewind, whatever you have to do. That's pretty much all I got for you. We'll start here. I made myself a little pad with some sticks. This little yoga spot, top of the world, just for you. Okay, and we begin. I'll get you to start in a seated position. So preferably with your legs crossed, but if that's not possible, if it's really hard on the knees, then just go with your knees up. Give yourself a bit of a hug. What we're looking for is a nice tall spine. You want to sit up nice and tall, work on your posture first, right? So we're going to sit up nice and tall. You're going to get your ribs off your hips, get your shoulders tucked into your back, and then relax them down. And then you're going to hold that posture for a few minutes here, but it's really important to work those little muscles surrounding your upper spine, right? That's our posture. That's how we stand around. That's how we present ourselves. We want to work on that posture. We want to be standing up taller. We want to be standing up more proud. You want to be walking through life with more confidence. So when you work on your posture like that, you gain a lot of height in your regular posture and your regular presentation of yourself. And you absorb the energy. You absorb energy from people and nature a lot more freely because your heart is more open to it, right? So we're going to tuck our shoulders into our back, relax them down, and we breathe. Now it's really important to clear our minds before we start getting into physical practice, because you really have to develop that mind to muscle relationship through in yoga. So you must calm your mind before you start. So this is where we start to work with our breath. Big inhales, big exhales, preferably through the nose. If it helps to clear your mind, you can count your inhales. 1, 2, 3, 4. Hold it at the top. Exhale. 1, 2, 3, 4. Or 5 or 6 or whatever your favorite number is, right? Make it your own. But just use that to clear your mind. That's meditation. Just clearing your mind, taking a step back, and being in the present moment. We always stress over the future. What are we going to do? How are we going to do it? We always dwell on the past. Why did we do that? We should have done something else. But really, all we have control over is right here, right now, the present moment. So let's take our minds, be in the present moment, and make the best of the present moment. As we feed our mind, our body, and our soul through yoga. Gonna get uncomfortable up in between your shoulder blades, but tuck them back and engage those muscles up in the top of your back. work with your breath, filling your stomach first. Now your chest. You can put your hand there if you like. Directing your breath to different parts, it helps you work the diaphragm in your lungs, and it really, really helps your focus to direct your breath to maybe a certain muscle, or maybe a certain part of the body. Once you start directing your breath there, then you're directing energy there. And it's said to be a natural way of healing yourself. It's just focusing on the pain, focusing on the discomfort, sending your breath there, sending your prana, your energy, to that target area in your body. Where do you want to send your breath today? You want to send it to your mind for relaxation? You want to send it to your heart to help you strengthen your emotions? Or do you want to send it somewhere physical, somewhere you want to strengthen, or somewhere you want to work on? Alright, we'll get out of this uncomfortable seated position. Bring ourselves over into a tabletop position. So what we're looking for is our hands stacked underneath our shoulders, our knees underneath our hips. We're going to get our hips warmed up here, so we're going to do big hip circles. We're going to inhale, sit our hips back to our heels. Then we're going to swoop out to the right, and you're probably going to feel more tension on the sides, so spend a little bit more time there, right? Out to the right, exhale, loosen up that hip. Forward and off to the left, probably a little more tension there, so take some time. Let it unfold. Send your breath to that hip. And the other way, whichever way you were going, switch it up. We'll shake that off, and then we'll get into a little bit of balance stuff here. So working on your core, working on your stabilizers. Give you a few different options, right? Option one, you're gonna stay on your knees, right hand comes up, left leg goes back. You're looking for length, not height. So you're gonna reach those fingertips through the front, you're gonna drive that heel through the back. Engage your arm, engage your leg, engage your core, hold it for 3 breaths. Engage. Flex your glutes. And release that. Left hand comes up, right leg goes back. Engage your leg, engage your arm, engage your core. 3 breaths. That, shake it off if you'd like. Now option two, get a little bit more crazy with it, get a little more challenging, right? You can come up into a plank, or if the other one was good enough for you, you can stay down on your knees. You come up into a plank, you're gonna go wide with your feet, wide with your hands. You're gonna shift your weight over to the left a bit, lift your right arm, lift your left leg. 3 breaths. And release that, give it a shake. And we go to the other side. Up into your plank. Shift your weight over to the right side this time. Left hand comes up, right leg comes up. Three breaths. And we're gonna release down in the child's pose. So knees as wide as your mat, toes together behind you. Send your hips back to your heels as far as you can. And you're gonna fold into your thighs. If you wanna get a little stretch out of it, you can spider your fingers until you feel a nice stretch down your lats and the back of your triceps. And then you fold into that. Before we get too lazy, we'll come back up. Gonna do a little more work, gonna do a little more warm up, and we'll get into some deep stretches. Okay, so we're gonna come back into our tabletop position, tuck our toes, hips up towards the sky. Keep your knees bent to start. I want your hips up as high as you can, drive your chest as far to your toes as you can. Then straighten out your legs, drop your heels. Should feel a nice stretch through the back of your legs. Okay, I'm gonna get into some movement here. So right leg's gonna come up, you're gonna drive that heel through the back. Drop the left heel. Feel that intense stretch through your left leg. Then we're gonna shift forward, keeping your butt down, right knee to the right elbow, Spider-Man plank, hold it for three breaths. Option to push up here. One more breath. Right leg comes up. Drive it through the back, drop the left heel. Feel that stretch in the left leg. Right toes come down, left side this time, left foot through the back, drop the right heel. Feel that stretch. Now we shift forward, butt down, Spider-Man plank, left knee to left elbow. Hold it, engage your arms, engage your core. Three breaths. Left foot comes up, drop that right heel, feel that. Left toes come down, knees as wide as your mat, toes together, child's pose. Now we're gonna go through a little inverted child's pose. So we're gonna walk our hands out to the right about a foot and a half, 2 feet. Left fingertips, spider away. Feeling a stretch to the left side body right off the bat. Then you fold over top of that right thigh. And then you can take your right hand, you plant your palm with your elbow up, and you can twist into it. You can twist into it if you want to. Feel that down your lower back. Okay, then we're gonna go to the other side. Walk our hands out to the left, about a foot and a half, 2 feet. Right fingertip spider. Fold over top of that left thigh. Now the left hand comes up, plants. And you can give it a little twist if you'd like. All right, back to center. Up in the tabletop position. And we're gonna tuck our toes back up in your downward facing dog. Everything pretty much roots from your downward dog, right? Right leg's gonna come up, inhale, drop the left heel, exhale. Inhale, right leg comes through, drop the left knee. A few different options here. Option one, low lunge. Use your leg for leverage, get up tall, get your ribs off your hips, square yourself up to the front of the mat, and then we lunge into it. Feel a nice deep stretch through your left hip flexor. If you're just looking for a stretch, stay here. I like to stay here a lot of the times because I'm working my legs a lot, right? Just looking for the stretch. If you're looking to tone up the legs a little bit, you can tuck those back toes, come up on that left knee, and do a high lunge. Same thing, tall spine, use your leg for leverage. Left knee's gonna wanna get lazy, so lift it up. Option 3, plug your fingers into the sky for warrior 1. Exhale, hands frame the front foot, front right foot, right foot kicks back. Left foot comes up, drop the left heel, drop the right heel. Left kick swings on through. Start off in our low lunge. Spine tall, ribs off your hips, crown your head up. Use your leg for leverage, square your hips up with the front of the mat, front of the room, whatever, and then we lunge into it. Alright, tuck the toes if you'd like, come on up. High lunge, tall spine, lunge in, back knees lazy, get it up. Lunge a little deeper. Option 3, plug your fingers into the sky, warrior 1. Exhale, hands frame the front left foot comes back, downward facing dog. Right foot comes up again, drop the left heel. Inhale, right foot sweeps up in between the hands. We're going to drop the left heel down. So your foot's about parallel to the back of the mat, or about 445, 45 or 90 degrees back there. You want your heel lined up with the arch of of the other foot. Then we're going to windmill, left hand starts. Windmill arms up and then warrior 2. So you want a straight left leg. You want a nice, your knee's going to want to fall in. We're going to open that up, arms come up in paradox, plugging them into the sides, and then we exhale, lunge into it. Gazing over top of our right front fingertips. Two more breaths. Reverse windmill, framing the right front foot, right foot comes back, left foot comes up, drop the right heel. Left foot comes on through, up in between the hands. We drop the right heel, line up our heel with our arch, windmill arms up, open up that right hip, that left knee, straighten the right leg, arms come up in paradox, and we lunge. Warrior 2 is meant to represent an ancient warrior goddess that used a bow and arrow. So if you like to shoot some arrows, go for it. Two more breaths. Have a little fun with it, right? Reverse windmill, hands the frame right. Left front foot, left foot comes back. Right foot comes up, drop the left heel. Kick the right foot up in between the hands. Same thing, drop the left heel. Windmill your hands up like you're going in the warrior 2, but tuck that left hand behind your back. Right hand salutes the sky, the sun. Peaceful warrior, same thing. Right knee wants to open up. Reverse windmill to frame the front right foot. Right foot comes back. Left foot comes up. Drop the right heel. Inhale, kick that left foot on through. Drop that right heel. Windmill hands up like you're going to warrior 2. Tuck the right hand behind the back. Left hand salutes the sky, the sun. And we lunge. Reverse windmill, hands to frame the left front foot, left foot comes back, downward facing dog. Now we're going to shift forward into a plank pose, plank position, elbows tucked into your ribs, slowly lower the count of 3, 2, 1, hold it, and release. Now we're going to do some upper body stretches here. So we're going to start with our shoulders. This one you can take anywhere with you. You can take it to bed with you if you like. Right hand's going to start out in front of us. We're going to reach those fingertips forward. So you feel a nice stretch of that right side body. Left hand's gonna come up, thread underneath the right and across, and you're gonna spider those right fingertips, those left fingertips across, and then the right forward. So you're stretched right out, then you exhale and fold into it. Spend a few breaths here. Take your time. Feel that left deltoid just falling open. Send your breath there. Send your concentration there. Imagine that muscle just peeling apart. Releasing all that lactic acid buildup. Two more breaths. Slowly coming out of that. And then go to the other side. Oh, give it a little shake if you'd like. So left hand reaches. Spider your fingers forward. Right hand comes up, threads underneath the left and across. And then you spider the left fingers, spider the right fingers. Find that point of stretch and then exhale into it. Fall into that right shoulder. You drop the left shoulder for a little bit more. You just roll over to the left side. Your hand can be planted or top up, whatever's up to you, whatever feels good for you. Find the tension and bring attention to the tension. Okay, slowly coming out of that. Now we're gonna go into some chest stretch. So we're gonna bring our arms out like cactus. We're gonna start with the left foot. We're gonna bring the right knee up. We're gonna plant the right chest, and we're gonna twist over to the right side using our left hand for leverage. Keep that right arm at a cactus arm, right? Like a cactus arm. Exhale into it. Feel that chest just fall apart. All right, slowly coming out of that. Okay, now we go to the other side. So left chest planted, right foot comes up, right knee comes up, twisting over to the left side using that right hand for leverage, planting that left chest. Alright, slowly coming out of that. While we're down here, we'll work on some back strengthening stuff, some lower back strengthening. It's really important because that's usually the muscles that you pull first, right? When you're doing your daily routines, your daily jobs or whatever. So we'll work on those muscles in our lower back. So work on engaging them and focusing on engaging those muscles down here, right? So we'll go into our Superman. So arms out in front, legs behind you. We're gonna lift up and engage that lower back for 5 breaths. The more you engage your core, the more you can get higher. Three, four, five, release. Then we're gonna go over to the sides. So you're gonna pop up, get that left hip off the ground. So you're just balancing on your right hip. For 3 breaths, engage your core. All right, release that, same thing on the other side. Get up off that right hip. And release. And we're gonna bring ourselves back into our child's pose to counter stretch that. All right, don't be afraid to grab water too whenever you need. Okay, so while we're down here, find ourselves in a nice, whatever kneeling position, whatever's good for you. You want to sit up nice and tall. We go through some neck stretches here. Really important to work on that tension that's built up in our shoulders and up in our neck. There's so much tightness there, right? I know I'm always tight there, right? So sitting up nice and tall, take our right hand, we're going to bring it behind our back, tuck it in your waistband or just kind of let it hang out, whatever's good for you. And the left ear is going to come over to the left shoulder. Drop it down there, and you might be looking up. You might be looking down. You might have your gaze forward. Whatever the tension is for you, whatever that juicy spot is, find it. And just work on it. Send your breath there. Exhale, relax it, and let it open up. A couple different options here. You can just let your head do the work, or you can push down on that right shoulder. Or you can reach around, grab a hold of the right side of your head with your left, give it a little help. Or I like to go in back of it, dig my hands in, and really dig into that muscle up into our neck, up into the shoulder there. Give it a nice deep tissue, right, as you're stretching it. Spend a few breaths here. Link your breath to that shoulder. Link your breath to that neck. Slowly coming out of that. Shrug if you'd like. Same thing. Find yourself a nice tall seat. Left hand goes behind your back. Right ear to the right shoulder. Direct your breath. Releasing that. Your shoulders a couple shrugs. Okay, then we'll come into some wrist stretches. We're gonna take our hands out in front of us. We're gonna flip them down. We're gonna tuck them so that our fingers are pointed towards our knees. We're gonna straighten out our arms. And you can walk your knees back if you like, or just shift your weight back, but keep your arms straight. And just sit back, shift the weight back a little bit. You'll feel a nice deep stretch through your forearms. It's really important for circulation too, right? When you're stretching like that, it helps your circulation. Every time you breathe, your lungs pick the blood or pull the blood back towards the organs. It's really important to breathe. Stretch and direct your breath, right? Slowly coming out of that. Rotate your wrists a couple ways each way. And we're gonna do the same thing, but we're gonna flop our hands forward this time. Tuck them underneath. Straighten out our arms, shift our weight back, probably only a couple inches to get that feeling, get that stretch. Now lift your pinkies, and then your ring fingers, and your middles, index, thumbs. Try to make a fist. Slowly coming out of that. Take that off. Okay, now we're going to come into our tabletop position again. This solid tabletop, tucking our toes, sending our hips up with our knees bent to start. Chest drives towards your toes, and then you straighten out your legs, drop your heels. Right leg's gonna come up, drive it through the back, drop the left heel. Inhale, swing that right leg up, in between your hands, drop the left knee. We're gonna go into a nice quad stretch here. Okay, same thing as your low lunge. Square your hips, tall spine, crown your head up, and we're gonna lunge into it for a couple breaths. Now our left hand is going to plant somewhere out by the side of our mat. You might want to shuffle your left knee forward if you can't get there, but your right hand is going to come behind your back. You're going to kick that left foot up in your hand. If you still can't get there, grab a shoestring or a strap or something, wrap it around your ankle, and pull it in. What you're looking for is a dragon pose. So you shift your hips forward, you're going to feel a nice deep stretch through your quad. Now you open up your hip, open up your right hip, your knee, and come on the outside of your right foot. And you open up your chest to the sky, and then you give your arm, you pull on your left foot with your right hand. Give it a little pull, open up a little deeper, exhale. If you want more out of it, you just shift your hips forward. Spend a few breaths here, it's really important. Big muscle group, right? And we can slowly release out of that. Hands frame the right front foot, left toes tuck, left leg comes up, right leg comes back into our downward facing dog. Left foot comes up, drive it through the back, drop the right heel. Left foot swings on through, dropping the right knee, coming up into your low lunge. Find your lunge first. Feel that stretch in your hip flexor for two breaths first. Okay, now right hand plants. Left hand comes back. Kick that right foot up into the left hand. Hold that first. Give it a little bit of torque. Feel the stretch. Exhale, release that right quad. Release it. Let it open up. Now the left knee opens up, come on the outside of the left foot, shifting your hips forward, and then pulling back on that right foot. Deep, intense quad stretch. Really send your breath to that muscle. Close your eyes and imagine that muscle relaxing. That right quad. Focus. Relax it. And get a little deeper. Exhale. And releasing that right foot, framing the left front foot. Left foot comes back into your downward facing dog. Now we're going to walk our feet up to our hands with a straight leg into a forward fold. So what you're looking for in your forward fold is your upper body just dangling. You can tuck, I like to tuck my chin into my chest, give my head a little bit of help in the back. Feel that nice stretch all the way down your spine, all the way back to your heels, right? Now we're going to inhale up to halfway lift. We're going to tuck our shoulders into our back. Engage those muscles like when we started class. Tuck them in there. Engage those muscles. Exhale, fold. Inhale, tuck the shoulders, halfway lift, looking forward. Exhale, fold. Inhale, reverse swan dive. Back straight, flat back. Reverse swan diving up. Saluting the sun. Exhale, hands down through heart center. Pushing the negative dark energy down and out. Inhale, bright, positive sunlight, happy, beautiful energy. Okay, now we'll get into a little bit of balance stuff because I know you like that. Okay, so we'll go with, we'll play around with tree a little bit. So what you want is to plant, we'll start with our left foot, plant your left foot solid into the ground. Imagine there's roots flowing through your foot, the bottom of your foot, into the ground, solid. You're not going anywhere. Your foundation, you're a pillar. Your leg's a pillar. You have a solid foundation, right? So now the right foot's going to start to get a little bit heavy, or a little bit light. Two options. You can go on your calf, solid leg, solid left leg, or you can go up into your thigh. Solid left leg, solid foot. Drive them into each other, and then we open up that right hip. And we spread our branches of our tree wherever you'd like. You can go down, all the way open. You can bring them up to the prayer center, whatever you like. Solid left leg, solid foot into that leg, right foot into the left leg. If you want to challenge yourself, you can start to gaze up or even close your eyes. Either way, whenever you decide to come out of it, come out with ease. Right foot comes down. Left leg's probably on fire. Give it a little love, give it a little shake. And then we go to the other side. Right foot, roots through your foot into the ground. Solid foundation, solid leg. Left toes start to get light. Whichever you did on the other side, whatever's comfortable for you. Engage your right leg. Engage your left foot, open up that left hip, then your branches can flow. Slowly, with ease. Left foot comes down, branches. Shake off that right foot. We'll go into a nice deep groin stretch here. So we're gonna bring our feet duck foot about a little wider than shoulder. So we're gonna inhale our arms up overhead. Exhale, we're gonna squat down with our elbows in between our knees. Tuck our elbows into our knees and open up our groin. Sometimes it's nice to plant your hands and just let your body weight shift your hips into your elbows. Whatever works for you, right? Just get that groin wide open. And here I'll give you the opportunity, if you want to start working with crow, you can plant your hands. Nice wide foundation. A little wider than shoulder. I like to tuck my knees into my elbows. Imagine your, or into your triceps, sorry, knees into your triceps. Glue your knees to your triceps. And then your triceps are like your shelves. So the more flat your shelf is, the more your knees are going to sit on it. They're not going to want to roll off, right? So if you can get your triceps nice and flat, and then you can slowly start to shift your weight forward. Don't ever bomb it. Slowly start to shift your weight forward. And then lean to one side a little bit. Let one toe come up first, and then the other one starts to get light. Maybe you come into your curl. Back into a nice groin stretch. Give give you a few minutes to play with that if you like. Okay, whenever you're ready, we'll find ourselves on our backs, laying flat. So we'll go through a little bit of back work here. Start with our right knee, give it a big hug, bring it in your chest. Right leg goes down, left knee up in your chest. Okay, we're gonna do a little bit of hip stretching here. So right knee is gonna come up, plant your right foot flat on the floor. Left foot's gonna come across, but you wanna really flex that left foot so you protect your knee, right? I'm gonna go into a nice right hip flex, right hip stretch. So hands are gonna come through. I prefer to go into my thigh, so then I can use my left elbow to open up my left hip. But if you want to go through and grab a hold of your shin, that's totally up to you. Make sure your left foot's flexed. Open up that left hip. Pull that right leg in. Sorry, it's a left hip flex stretch. This one. And we'll release that, both feet flat. Right foot comes to the outside of the left thigh. Right foot flexed, protect your knee. Right hand, or both hands go in, grab a hold of that thigh, that leg from underneath. Right elbow can go on the inside of the right thigh and open it up. Feel that in the right hip flex stretch. Alright, slowly release that. Now left foot's gonna come down. We're gonna bring the right knee up into our chest. Right, left hand's gonna come across, grab a hold of that right, the outside of that right leg. Right hand's gonna come out and you're gonna gaze over top of those right fingertips. Now you're gonna shift your hips so that they're stacked up and down now. And you're gonna use your left hand to help your right leg and twist over, looking over that right shoulder. Nice spinal twist. Breathe into this one. Don't overdo it. It's really important that you do a spinal twist because now it's wringing out all the toxins in your organs. You got all kinds of stuff built up in there, right? In your spine and your organs, right? It's good to twist that stuff out, wring it out. Alright, slowly coming out of that. And because it's a spinal twist, you don't want to counter twist too hard, too fast, because then you're defeating the purpose, right? And you could hurt yourself. So left knee comes up in your chest, right hand comes to the outside of that left knee. Left hand goes out to the left, gazing over the left shoulder, stacking the hips up and down. Right knee, left knee comes out to the right side. And we breathe. Slowly coming out. Laying flat, let your spine neutralize. Okay, now we're gonna do a little bit of core work. So, a couple different options. You wanna get intense with it, you wanna challenge yourself, you can come up into a crunch position. Otherwise, you can bring your hands out to the side, wherever you want. We're gonna start by lifting our feet 6 inches. 5 breaths.
Now out to the right, 6 inches up. Engage your obliques. Crunch into that oblique. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Out to the left this time. Crunch into that left oblique. 6 inches up. Back to the center. 3 breaths. Release. Soles of your feet together, knees wide open for 3 breaths. 1. Inhale, exhale, sigh. Next exhale, horse lips. Okay, back to it. Crunch position if you'd like. Legs up, 6 inches. 3 breaths. Out to the right, 2 breaths. Out to the left, 2 breaths. Back to the center, up 6 more inches, 3 breaths. Out to the right, 3 breaths. Out to the left, 3 breaths. Back to the center, all the way up, toes overhead, reach for your toes, 3 breaths. Slowly lower, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Release, soles of your feet together, knees wide open, 3 breaths. Option 2, sigh and horse lips on breath number 2 and 3. Okay, feet together, one more sequence. We're gonna go out to the right, we're gonna go rainbows with our legs. So inhale up to the center, exhale down to the left. Inhale up to the center, exhale down to the right. Inhale up to the center, exhale down to the left. 3 more on each side. One. One more, back and forth. Inhale back to the center, slowly lower. 3, 2, 1. Release everything, Shavasana. Palms facing up, feet fall open. Give your body a little scan, relax your feet, relax your legs, relax your hips, relax your shoulder and your chest. Relax your eyebrows and your tongue.
I'd like to say a nice little quote while we're in Shavasana. Every stranger that you meet knows something that you don't. So absorb foreign knowledge with an open, positive state of mind. Because you never know when a stranger could change your perspective on life.
stay in Shavasana for as long as you'd like. When you're ready, bring a little awareness back to your body by wiggling your fingers and your toes, your wrists and your ankles. Bring your knees in your chest and give yourself a big hug. Roll over and then sit up at your own pace, at your own time. Find ourselves in a nice seated position, like when we started class. Tall spine, shoulders tucked. We're gonna work on those posture muscles in your back for 3 more breaths. From the bottom of my heart, I send much gratitude to you for letting me share my love of yoga and for getting me up this hill. If you have any questions, don't be afraid to ask. Namaste, Eric.